Our sort of goal is that we want to enable community entrepreneurship. So we've already discussed with a lot of community builders here that community building is, very similar to running a startup. So you have a lot of similarities between community builders and entrepreneurs. So we thought that some of these skills are similar. So why don't we enable people who want to become entrepreneurs to become community builders and earn out of it? So here is how we started. Before this, I used to run this social network of doctors called Curify. Had about 50% of Indian doctors using it primarily to discuss cases with each other. Think of it like a Stack Overflow for doctors. Eventually sold it, exited. It's been more than 2 years now. When I exited, I sort of thought that this is a space that I cannot leave, especially the community side of things that Kirupa used to focus on community engagement, and that is what I loved. And I thought that, I was a community entrepreneur, and I've seen the power of communities, and I want to help others, build communities, run communities. However, the whole start happened with a small incident that I was talking to one of my friend who had moved to Canada, and he told me that it's really lonely out there, and it's very, very difficult to find belonging. He told that it's easy to find meetings, but it's difficult to find belonging. And that is what he was craving for. And we were just chatting. I was telling him about one of the other WhatsApp groups that I had recently discovered. It was, the entrepreneurs from my college, and, it was really, really powerful. There was a good mix of professionalism as well as informality in that. So I told him about that group, and few days later he messaged me saying that, hey, I found someone who is an Indian, and he referred me to this WhatsApp group of us in Canada, in his city. And he felt so good about it. And that's when I thought that it would be really, really powerful and awesome to help people discover such engaging communities where they feel belong to. And that's when, I sort of started committing myself. It was a process, but I think that moment felt like an epiphany for me. Committed myself to work on helping community building and community discovery. When I really started on, I realized that one, WhatsApp is amazing, but WhatsApp and some of the other platforms like Telegram, Slack, they were not built for communities. They are being used for communities, mostly because the current way the social media is built, it is designed for content consumption rather than, relationship building. And that's why there is a huge need of finding communities and building communities. And I wanted to enable that. General problems like there are a lot of random chats, in especially in platforms like WhatsApp, which are more popular in our country. You cannot go beyond 20, 30 active member, in your community on WhatsApp. You cannot follow specific conversations, and there were like a lot of problems in terms of discovering things other than chats, like events and whatever offerings the community manager is offering. So started, with this mindset that, I just need to make people discover awesome communities, and everything will happen by itself. So what we started doing was, very geeky. We started creating these system-generated communities. When we, like, the first version of the product was that we had about 50,000 communities created on a very beautiful algorithm from what I thought at that time. People came, people joined, but they didn't do anything. And I realized a very, very important thing, that we were approaching the whole thing from the wrong side. It's almost the same time that Paras had also joined, and we started discussing that we have to solve for one of the biggest thing in this whole ecosystem that we had created, that we need people to manage these communities. And that's when we started focusing more on the other side, started getting some interns, because we had to build the product, and generally asking someone to shift from, let's say, WhatsApp, Telegram, Slack to a new platform generally required our people to build it out and test it out, at least in the product building phase. So we got some interns onboarded, the picture that you see is one of the best interns that we had at that time, and there is a story behind it which I'll cover on later. Once the platform became a little more mature, we started onboarding some of the communities. They were not being monetized at that time. Some of the enthusiasts who we could find from our own network got to use the platform, gave us feedback. Eventually, what we learned in the next 6 months was this, that community builders need a lot of tools. It's not an easy job. It is very similar to how entrepreneurs need these tools, and community builders didn't have those tools. So, there was no tool for onboarding. There was no profile directory, no permission settings. Event experience was very disjointed. No native payment integration for especially, people who wanted to monetize their communities to sustain for long run. And there was no analytics and marketing tools. Now, to solve this, there could be two approach. One is you build like a lot of these tools which can be used on top of existing platforms. But we chose the latter. We thought we want to go full stack. And that's why what we built today is something for people like Garv, who are community entrepreneurs, who are creators, who want to create value, but to a specific community and monetize without getting dependent on the ads, but via the people who they are delivering value to. We feel that this is a very, very sustainable model, has existed in the offline world for a while now, but hasn't been replicated so far so well in the online world. And we want to change that. We want to enable that. I want to highlight Garv's journey. I spoke to him in April. He was running 6 WhatsApp groups, 1 Telegram group. He was using 5-6 tools for managing the community, managing analytics, managing registrations and whatnot. What was his ask was a simple integrated solution with some automation to manage the whole experience of hosting his daily shows. Now, once he got onboarded, we did some migration, got his existing members. I think one of the biggest thing that we could empower him was he used to run these WhatsApp groups, but they were broadcast groups. But on Like Minds, he was able to enable members to talk to each other and drive belongingness. I think that to me was one of the biggest value that we could give him early on. Over time, we matured, started doing more and more integrations. Very recently, day before yesterday, we did this, that we, like the URL that you saw, garvmalik.com, that is powered by us. I think I'm very, very proud to say that when I spoke to him, his existing website was powered by himself. Now he's relying on us, I'm very, very proud to say that. Other integrations as well. And now I think his community is fairly strong and ready to scale. There is a huge belongingness in his community. In July itself, there were more than 2,000 messages exchanged in very, very 5 engaging chat rooms. He has about 90 paid subscribers already. He's already collaborated with a lot of comedians to host these shows. So I feel that he's ready to scale, and I'm proud to power that. The next journey is of the same intern that, who we had started working with in the early days. But once the platform matured and we realized that, we want to empower community entrepreneurs, we pitched her that, why don't you explore, starting a new community in the same domain, but with the entrepreneurship mindset. And she did that. She used to also run a Facebook group like before she joined us, primarily focused, awareness around well-being. She chose to start a paid membership community with us. Started scaling quickly. We helped her with the strategies and a little bit of marketing push. I think one of the very, very interesting things that she did to drive belongingness in her community was these chat room based challenges. So imagine chat room to be very, very similar to like subgroups in your community. She used to run like very interesting monthly, weekly challenges, and there was a lot of engagement on that. Because of that belongingness, she started seeing very high renewals other communities, and now today she has more than 100 members. She's also launched her own wellness programs beyond the paid membership that she's running, and she's already sold some of them. And recently, you know, we started this startup program to support some of the more matured community entrepreneurs, and she's recently joined that. So again, one of the most proud moment for me. One last case study I want to talk about is for this beautiful, I don't have an adjective to add, but let's just say mom. She was a mom blogger. I knew her from past. She was, not looking to build a community. She was just an enthusiast who, was wanting to connect with other mom bloggers. She was blogging her own journey, but I somehow convinced her to explore like minds. And this is back when we were running communities via interns. So the platform was not stable, but her value proposition was very, very clear. I think she has identified a great niche. Because of that, very, very quickly, the community started scaling and getting engagement. I think in the early days, she was juggling between, her own being a homemaker versus running a community. She came up with this beautiful program called 1 Week CM. I think we've already spoken a lot about it. There is a YouTube video on it. I won't go in a lot of details, but the idea was to make members your community managers for 1 week. It turned out really well, increased a lot of belonging. In February, she started doing a lot of events because we started building features around events. And she's been lovely in terms of just following whatever we've been guiding her with. She also started a volunteer program, and I think today she has more than 10 volunteers in her team who are managing most of the things for her. Created a lot of content because of the members on Instagram to support the growth. And eventually, when we launched the paid membership, after focusing on creators, she transitioned her community into paid membership community, launched a membership program. Because of the high engagement, got a lot of members to pay for it. And today her community is profitable, has about 110 paid members. 3,500 messages were exchanged in July in her community, with 60% of her members creating content in either of the chat rooms in her community on a weekly basis. This is phenomenal. By far, 60% creators in a community I haven't heard of in any community so far in my life. So really, really powerful journey, I would say, that she's had. So who are we? We are enablers of community creation and monetization. So we enable creators to convert their audience into a branded community and sell digital products like these, memberships, events, group chats, consultations, courses. And our core value proposition is to build a branded community and monetize it. We have created a whole product around the general customer cycle. So you acquire your customers, you retain them, you make the most out of it by renewals or upselling, and then you generate referrals. I'm not going to get you into all the details, but just wanted to touch that. We've been able to help 100 plus community entrepreneurs in last 3 months since we focused on this niche of helping community builders become entrepreneurs or helping creators start their own entrepreneurship driven community. Our vision is to now set up a million entrepreneurs for success. And we feel that we've just started and we'll definitely achieve it. To do that, we've started creating an ecosystem around it because we feel that it's very important to create it, especially in our country. So we've launched, certain learning courses. This whole report of State of Indian Community Management is one part of the whole thought process around creating this ecosystem in India. And then today's event is our, first flagship event in the series. We plan to do it, deciding the frequency. Please ping in the chat if you feel, what would be the ideal frequency to do this.